Despite all the marketing, you don't have to spend hundreds of dollars a month to prevent identity theft and hacking. There are free tools available, and although they may not have all of the features that the premium tools do, if you're on a budget, it's 100 times better than doing nothing. Hey there, welcome to another All Things Secured video. My name's Josh, and today I'm gonna be walking you through 7 absolutely free tools that you can be using today to prevent online identity theft and hacking. Each of these tools has a specific purpose. So in other words, I'm not gonna be giving you redundant recommendations, and I suggest you look through all of them to make sure you're covering all your bases. Number 1, Bitwarden, which is a free open source password manager app. If you're still creating your own passwords or writing them down on a piece of paper, you need to transition yourself over to a password manager app. Password manager apps like Bitwarden make it so much easier to create strong passwords, store them behind a master password, and then retrieve them conveniently whenever you're logging into your various accounts. Now, like I said, there are premium versions available. I use one called 1Password and I pay for it on an annual basis. But if you're on a budget and you just need that password manager, Bitwarden's the way to go. Number 2, your free credit report check. Did you know that you have the right to check your credit once a year with each one of the major credit bureaus, Equifax, Experian, and TransUnion? This means that every 4 months you could cycle through all 3 of the credit bureaus to get a free credit report and check that report for any suspicious activity. The things that you're looking for here are maybe bank accounts that you don't recognize, credit cards that you didn't open, or even addresses that aren't yours. If you find something that looks weird, you need to act on that fast. Contact the bank or the credit card issuer or even the credit bureau to make sure that that gets corrected as soon as possible. The third tool I'll mention here is Signal or Telegram. We're currently inundated with so many communication apps, including Facebook Messenger, WhatsApp, iMessage, Skype, you name it, but very few of them offer the same zero-knowledge end-to-end encryption that Signal and Telegram do. Essentially, what you're doing here is securing your communication with certain individuals. Obviously, you're not going to do this with everybody, but making sure that your most sensitive conversations are done on an encrypted platform like Signal or Telegram. This fourth one's a big one, so listen up. If you're not using 2-factor authentication right now, you need to stop what you're doing and make sure that you turn that on for your banking, email, and investment accounts immediately. 2-factor authentication is basically a second way beyond just your password of verifying your identity. It can be done via a phone, via text, or even via a key that you have to plug into your computer or connect via Bluetooth. Now, I've already gone into greater detail about what 2-factor authentication is and how you can set it up in this video you see here, but I just want to emphasize the fact that this is probably one of the easiest free ways that you can secure all of your online accounts right now. The fifth tool that I'd like to recommend here is that you switch to a browser like Firefox. If you're one of the millions of people that are currently using Chrome while logged into your Gmail account, consider just how much data you are giving over to Google, even if it is anonymized data. It's surprisingly easy to migrate all of your settings and all of your bookmarks from Chrome to Firefox. And because Mozilla's business model doesn't rely on data collection like Google's does, you have just a little bit of extra privacy there. The sixth free tool I'm going to share with you is one that you probably didn't know existed or that you even needed, and it's one called Redirect Detective. You see, we often come across links in our email or in social media or elsewhere that have been shortened using tools like Bitly, Owly, or TinyURL, or many others. The problem is, we don't know where that shortened URL is sending us. It could be sending us to a legitimate website, and most of the time it does, but it could also be sending us to a malicious website that's meant to steal our data or download something onto our devices. A tool like Redirect Detective allows you to copy and paste the shortened URL into their tool to find out where it eventually leads to and whether or not that's a legitimate website. Now, mind you, you probably don't have to do this for every single shortened URL you come across, but if you have suspicions, this is an excellent free tool that you should bookmark and use. The final tool I want to share with you is more of a setting than a tool. You see, every operating system, program, and app on your computer or mobile device is constantly being updated with new features, and in the process, they're also patching up any security vulnerabilities that they find in the code. By setting up automatic updates or at least notifications for updates, you can make sure that you're using the most secure, up-to-date version of the software. I'm not saying you need to use the beta version of any software, and you can even wait a couple days or a week to make sure that there's nothing that really needs to be fixed with any new versions that come out. But the fact is that you don't want to wait for months or a year to update any of this. You want to make sure that you are patching up all the security holes in the software that you have. So that's all I've got for you today. If you have any others that you'd like to add, put those in the comments. I want to hear what you have to say. If this video is useful, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the All Things Secured YouTube channel, where I continue to provide weekly videos on online security tips and tricks.